Welcome and be inspired with Dominic. Today I'm going to show you how I made these versatile boom arms. You can use them for your microphone, for homemade light panels, or like the one I put my camera on. Let me show you how I made them. And if you light me up one more time when I'm not in the dark, I donate you to a city college. And yes, they squeak too.
I start up by cutting length of plywood. They determine the reach of the arm as well as its bulkiness. I later shortened two of the three arms that I could make from this piece, so maybe put some thought into that beforehand. The main rule for this design is to attach the arms in such a way that both pairs have always the same distance to each other. That is, the ends have the same distance to each other. This is easier said, but also easily done. That did not make sense, but I hope this will. I resaw a piece of plywood to use as the knee, the joint between the two segments of the arm. You could call it an elbow, but seriously, would you rather have whatever tool you put on here elbow you or bend the knee to you? With the other holes in this piece of scrap, it's not as easily visible here, but I drilled two sets of two holes into this. Each pair is the same distance apart and they sit at an angle. I recommend something in the neighborhood of 45 degrees. That allows you to fold the arm all the way down. Depending on your geometry, you might have to cut a few corners to prevent interference. To keep the pieces from coming apart, we need two knee pieces to sandwich the slats. On a side note, the main rule mentioned earlier applies to both segments of the arm separately. In theory, you could use different distances for both pairs of struts, but in practice, using the same distance for both makes things a lot easier. For the ends of the arm, I used the same hole distance in two pieces of plywood each. Bolts come in handy to hold things together, to set the arm in such a way that you can move it, but that it holds position otherwise. Depending on the load that you put on, you can also open the joint, move it, and then fasten it again. More on that later. For now, I start with the base. If all you need is to move the arm in one direction, this base is enough to clamp or screw it to a table or workbench. To take it a step further, I wanted to pivot. To that end, I use a bolt and a T-nut. It works, but the bolt here gets in the way and prevents me from actually tightening the pivot bolt, and it might eventually come loose. More on that later, too. For now, I cobbled together a holder for this old scanner that I turned into a lamp using a LED strip. There are certainly more elaborate solutions for this, but I use a pivot point for two axes each, and it works well enough. The audience enjoys it at least. Coming back to the pivot section, I replace the base with a box and add a round disc with a bolt in it to thread into the T-nut from underneath. That allows me to clamp this to a bench and still tighten or loosen the pivot bolt. Using the first arm as a guide, it is obvious that I do not need an arm as long or unwieldy for my microphone. So I disassemble it and cut the pieces down. Make sure you align the holes and not the ends of the pieces, just in case you trimmed them earlier. Then I re-drill the holes and assemble the shorter version. Finally, a third arm is to hold my camera. While my microphone is light enough for wingnuts to do the trick, I want a little more grip here. So I drill two holes into a piece of scrap plywood that are slightly smaller than a nut, then add through holes for the corresponding thread. After hammering two nuts on a bolt into these, I cut the plywood in two and have two nuts with good grip. I could make them prettier, but they work.
This comes in handy for video shooting to get a little more light on the scene. But, like I said at the beginning, I also put my camera on such an arm, a shortened one. Let me see whether I can show you. I need to pull you out, so hold still. And there we go. Sorry, it's a little bit shaky, but that happens when you pull people out of cameras. And there we go, that's the boom arm, my camera's on. And as you can see, I probably saw it already. Used these nuts here, just hammered into a piece of plywood, and they work pretty well. Can extend the camera all the way. And I love the squeaking. As you can see, these boom arms are pretty versatile. You can use them for microphone, camera, light fixtures. You can also put a little tray on them to pull over to the workbench, to the part of the bench where you need certain tools or just something to put some stuff into. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this idea and how you would use it. Share it with your friends if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you think I earned it. And as always, remember to be inspired.